Here's a follow-up to my Icom IC-7610 screen capture video. Now in that and in previous videos, I indicated my displeasure over Icom choosing the power button to do a screen capture. Now as I showed in that video, to get a screen capture of what's currently on your screen, you just tap your power button and you'll get your screen capture. However, if you hold the power button a little bit too long, the rig shuts down. You will lose what you wanted to capture and you have to turn your radio back on again. I think that's a poor choice. Now, a viewer on my channel commented that if you hold it too long, it's your own fault, and he's right. I'm not disagreeing with that at all. But to me, using the power button for the screen capture is the equivalent of having a miles per gallon indicator on the start-stop button of your engine of your car. No manufacturer would ever do that. However, Icom has given us an alternative to using the power button, and thanks to Kent Eichstaedt, and I hope I'm pronouncing that correctly, we can now take a look at what that option is, and that way we don't have to use the power button for the screen capture. So let's check that out. In order to have an alternative to the power button to use the screen capture function, you have to have an external keyboard hooked up. So get one of those installed, and then you'll be all set. From there, we hit Menu. Then we go into Set, then we go to Function, and then we're going to have the Function menu. There's seven pages. We want to go to the seventh page, so we just scroll down here. We see the numbers dropping, or increasing actually, now to seven. And then we see at the very top of the seventh page, Screen Capture Keyboard Print Screen. Now, Kent Eichstaedt believes that this is something new on the version 1.06 firmware update. And I think he's right, although I'm not completely sure of that. So you may have to upgrade to version 1.06 before you get this option. But again, that I may not be totally correct on that. Regardless, it's sitting here on my radio, and we will tap that and we will turn that on. The other thing I want to talk about is you have a couple of different file types for screen captures. You either have PNG or bitmap files. You can choose either one. I choose PNG, although I don't think it really matters. I've got software that will convert either one of those to JPEG if necessary. Once that's done, we can exit out of there. And then, my keyboard's a little dirty here. And we have the print screen function. What I'm going to do is I'm going to press that and bang, there it goes. Didn't have to touch the power button at all. And I've got my screen capture. So there's an alternative to using the power button. I'm still going to keep that option on. You can actually turn off the screen capture function from the power button in the IC-7610, but I see no advantage or disadvantage to doing that, so I'm just going to leave that on. But now, from here on forward, I am going to use the print screen button on my keyboard versus touching the power button to get a screen capture. So why would you even want to do a screen capture? After all, Icom already gives you the ability to save the text data from RDI and PSK transmissions, and that's built into the 7610, and a viewer on my channel correctly pointed that out. But I think an actual image of the QSO itself, a pictorial record if you will, is a lot more sexy. Let's take a look at one I made, and I showed this in the last video. This is Tango November 5 radio from the Republic of the Congo, and this is the actual QSO moments after it happened. And you get to see the screen as it took place. And if for some reason you forgot to log it and you didn't have your data collection method running where it would save the text data, the time's right here at the top of the screen. So I think that's a pretty neat function that Icom put on here that I didn't initially appreciate that I do now. So thanks to Icom for giving us an alternative to the power button to do this screen capture. And I want to give a shout out to Kent Eichstaedt for pointing this out to me. I didn't know it was available, and now I do, and so do you. Thank you very much for watching, and 73 from WX0V.